What does a tool watch mean to you? For me personally, it means a watch is more than just a gimmick. Marketing dive, pilots, or even chronographs to associate them with their purpose is perfectly fine. After all, companies have to make money and there's nothing wrong with a bit of daydreaming. But to me, a true tool watch is built with a single purpose in mind: to serve as an essential tool for the job. In this case, and with a name like Marathon Search and Rescue, well, you already know, it was built to actually perform a task rather than just a marketing gimmick. So why Marathon? What makes this watch different from any other tough chronograph? One thing that makes Marathon very attractive to most enthusiasts is that they're one of the only brands that produce government-issue watches. The Canadian-based company focuses on military-specced watches, and the watch we have in front of us, for example, is built with actual government specifications in mind. The company that became Marathon Watch was founded in 1904 as Winstrom Watch, later became Wayne Brothers, and in 1939, Maurice Wayne founded Marathon Watch, supplying fine precision timepieces throughout North America. The CSAR, which stands for Chronograph Search and Rescue, is what I consider to be the king of their entire lineup. The size is the main factor that I feel needs to be taken into consideration, coming in at around 46mm by 18mm thick. This isn't a watch for the faint of heart. As I mentioned, the company's main focus is to make a watch as functional and tool-oriented as possible. Putting this watch on the wrist, you don't get a classic timepiece to wear with a suit, you get a watch that will serve a purpose. Personally, in this case, I don't mind the size. Coming from someone who prefers 40mm and under, the feeling you get when wearing this watch and its great legibility starts to make more sense while having it on the wrist. Should this have been a little bit smaller, the dial would be very cluttered and very hard to read, which kinda defeats the purpose. That said, the lug-to-lug distance, which means top to bottom, is around 55mm, which could be quite difficult for some to wear if they have very small wrists. A couple of other things to note: that you get a tritium loon treatment, you get anti-reflective sapphire crystal, and you get a 300 meters of water resistance, which is actually quite impressive for a chronograph. The screw-down pushers aid the watch to reach that specification. Now finally, the movement powering this piece is the ETA 7750, which is regarded as one of the best automatic off-the-shelf chronographs. The movement operates at 4 Hz with about 2 days of power reserve. It features a time, day-date calendar, and 12-hour chronograph. The good thing about the 7750 is any capable watchmaker should be able to service it, and the parts are readily available, so you don't have to worry about servicing it. Overall, while I do think this is a big watch, in this case, I actually forgive the size. The watch is a tool watch, and those who want to purchase this are looking for that feeling of a watch that's tough or actually needed for a purpose. This is one of the toughest watches I've ever experienced, and for under $5,000, I think it's a great purchase. This video is brought to you by Ticking Way, where we curate some of the most collectible watches in the world from brands like Alanganzuna, F.P. Jorn, Grandfeld, and many more. Every watch on our website is carefully curated by genuine watch collectors, so feel free to email us or book a call so we can discuss your next timepiece. The expert team over at Ticking Way will gladly assist you, so head over to tickingway.com when you consider your next luxury purchase.